OK 大家好欢迎来到我们元力趣的直播间。那我是本期的活动主持人柏林。那近期的话呢，我们一直推出了一系列的关于 Web 三系列的一些活动啊，Web 三里面先行者活动。这里面呢，不只有公链项目，也有非常好的一车子一些不同公链的这些生态项目。那我们今天的话呢，我们会一起给大家聊一下我们今天的非常重磅的一位。嘉宾也是非常重磅，在近期 Blockchain 生态也好，在整个 Metaverse 生态也好，一个非常受欢迎的一个项目叫 MoNA。Hey everybody, this is Tim from the first Web3 community. As you know, first Web3 community is a non-profit Web3 community, and now we are going to have a series of Web3 projects featured on our community. And today we invited Justin. Justin, he is the CEO of MoNA. And Justin, could you just say hi with our audience here?
Hey Tim, hey everyone. Thanks so much for having me. Super excited to be here and talk about Mona.
Okay, great. Yeah. 那 Justin 这边的话呢，他是MoNA 的 CEO，然后呢，我们也非常欢迎他来到我们本期的园区直播间这边。那他本身呢，也是一名视觉艺术家和作家。OK，那 Justin 他在增强现实，然后虚拟现实。动画、绘画，然后书籍制作、插图，然后雕塑、电影和互动体验，各个领域的话都非常多的一些自己的一些见解和深耕。那他的 AI 镜头，他制作非常好的一些 AI 镜头，已经在 Instagram 以及在Twitter 上面的浏览量已经超过了1亿次。OK，包括 Facebook 和 Snapchat 上面。那 Justin 的话，他目前正在致力于通过NFT 的探索艺术，然后媒体、时尚和娱乐的这种未来。Okay, yeah, we will talk about just tell you guys more about Justin. So Justin, he's actually a visual artist and he's also a writer. Yeah, Justin has always been deeply involved in the fields of augmented, reality, virtual reality, animation, painting, bookmaking, illustration, sculpture, film, and interactive experience. Yeah, wow, he has a lot of talent here. Yeah, and his AR lens have been viewed more than 100 million times, of course, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, and so many social medias. And now Justin is here and he will explore the future of art, media, fashion, and entertainment. Yeah, entertainment and with AMPs and absolutely metaverse. Okay. As you guys know, the world is repeatedly moving towards reality, where people spend very more and more time and your lives in the virtual worlds rather than the physical ones. Okay, so MoNA Gallery, they do create a shared specific art space by developing new jobs, hosting gallery bills, and providing high-quality art displays. And they bring, NFTs to the mainstream while keeping social interaction activities and building a high-fidelity 3D, as you guys know, this is very good. Yeah, 3D AMT environment entirely customized by the artist. Yeah, and what's more is, MoNA is they are seeding the open metaverse through the creation of beautiful, unique 3D spaces. A lot of great 3D spaces here, and you can check with Justin later on, and he will do a demo. Including the total complete system about multiplayer. Artists, royalties, interactive builders, and token gated access and events, and VR, AR all supported here, and with more interoperable, across the metaverse. In the future, there will be infinite ways to use your space. 那大家都知道，我们目前的世界的话，正在迅速走向一个可能现实和虚拟现实相关的一个部分。那可能。在未来的话，我们觉得更多的人群可能会生活在这样一个虚拟世界里面，而不是说在现实世界当中。当然，可能两个部分还是会并存啊，这是一个发展的这样一个阶段。那 MoNA 的话呢，他们其实为艺术家提供了这样一个特定的一个共享空间，然后用于开发新的产品、举办画廊的一些观看，甚至链接到其他的一些 gallery。那他们也在保持更多的社交活动，可以进入到我们的这样一个 metaverse 的这样一个3D space 里边，也可以把 AMT 的这样一个场景带入主流当中来，并且构建完全为艺术家定制的非常高保真的这种 3D 的这种 AMT 的环境。那更重要的是呢，他们正在创建一个非常非常非常非常漂亮，好像非常独特的这样一个 3D 的这样一个空间，然后为开放的这样一个元宇宙来 提供更多的一些好玩的东西。那其中我们可以看到有更多的一些类似多人游戏啊、艺术家版税啊，然后交互的构建器啊，或者是更多的一些 VR 和 AR 的这种支持，完整的这种系统，他们都在构建。那我们觉得，随着这样一个 Metaverse 的这样一个更多的可操作性呢，未来也会有更多无限的方式来使用这个空间。OK，那接下来我们的时间就交给 Justin 这边，他会给我们带来分享，就是 MoNA 如何是可以在里面 own 一个 space in the Metaverse。OK，so hi Justin，so we do have a very long introduction here. Sorry about that, but we have to let you know. Yeah, this is a very great project. We want everybody to know about your project. So I think that now it's time for you to do an introduction about MoNA, and you may try to do demo it also. Yeah, so I will stop my screen sharing, and you can share your screen now. OK.
Okay, great.
Okay, great. Yeah.
All right. So you can see this, right?
Yeah, it's pretty clear. Okay.
Perfect. Great. Well, thank you again, Tim. And thank you, everyone. Really excited to be here today to chat with you about MoNA. As you mentioned, really wonderful intro as well. Couldn't have said it better myself. But MoNA is a beautiful decentralized metaverse built for artists by artists. A little earlier this year, this is a project that began with two of my friends, Alex Patton and Matt Hurl, my two other co-founders. Alex is the Harvard Blockchain Innovation Fellow, and Matt comes from the world of Hollywood and film, and has been an AR venture producer and has about 12 AR patents. And so together, the three of us, we united under this idea that and realization that there wasn't a great way for 3D NFTs to be displayed and shared. And we saw existing metaverse platforms, and we were inspired by everything that was out there. And we wanted to create a very, very high quality solution for this. And then earlier this year, we were fortunate to be a part of the Tachyon Accelerator program that's backed by Filecoin. We dove into ways that we'd be able to use Filecoin and IPFS to help support this mission and vision. And in building MoNA, we realized that this was a broader vision, not just about displaying NFTs, but about creating beautiful metaverse spaces that are NFTs themselves, and those 3D assets being able to be minted and stored on IPFS. So really excited to dive into some spaces today with you and kind of show you what we're building.
Great, yeah. 那刚刚 Justin 这边的话，其实 Justin, I will Justin try to explain a bit more about your
Yep,
team and
perfect.
some background just now you mentioned here. OK，那其实刚刚 Justin 这边的话呢，有给我们带来更多的信息。但他提到，其实在今年的时候，他的三个团队的成员就是大家相互在一起，然后碰撞，开始有了 MoNA 这样一个 project。那其实另外的话也是非常重磅的啊，比如说他们在哈佛这边的区块链的研究员，然后包括他们在还有另外一位叫 Mate I think his name is Mate, right? Yeah, actually, I talked with him first and introduced you to be here today. Yeah, 那么这边的话其实也在整个的这样一个MoNA 的这样构建一个技术生态层面的话，也是做了非常多的这样一个研究和投入。那他们的话呢，近期也是参加了这样一个 Barcon 这边在做了一个叫 Tachyon 的这样一个项目 Tachyon Launchpad。那作为这样一个加速器的话呢，他们也是在整个的 Metaverse 那样一个project 里面，他们是脱颖而出的。对，也是受到了包括实验室官方团队以及包括我们更多的一些资本方的一些青睐。那我们接下来的话还是交给 Justin，让他给我们带来更多的分享。OK，Justin，you can continue now. Thank you.
Great, thank you so much. Yes, and so now I'm going to change my screen here to show you some metaverse spaces in MoNA. So you can see
Okay.
this now, right?
Yeah, it's pretty
Okay,
cool.
perfect. So now we're on our MoNA homepage. And I should preface this by saying earlier this year, actually in October, we partnered with Filecoin to create one of the, if not the largest metaverse build bounties ever. So Filecoin pledged to purchase in a reverse auction style format a set number of metaverse spaces in around the, which ultimately amounted to around $300,000 US. And, basically we, Filecoin helped us to begin to seed the creation of really, really incredible metaverse spaces. And so via the MoNA website, MoNA.gallery, you can actually dive in and start to explore some of the spaces that were created. And so again, all these spaces are being streamed directly from IPFS. And so anyone can access MoNA all within the web browser. So you don't need to download a separate game. You don't need to download anything. This is just running right inside of Google Chrome for me. And so this is one of the spaces here. Okay. And so you're able to just move around with your keyboard right now. But being accessible via the web browser is something that's really important to us. And this is going to enable us to be a platform, you know, to work across all platforms. And so while it's viewable in the desktop web browser right now, we're currently building out VR and AR support as well.
And great.
Yep, and I'll just say too, I'll just add, I encourage everyone to try this on your own computer. Because there's sound and spatialized audio as well. So it really helps you feel immersed. But okay, I'll let you.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. I tried it on my Chrome. Yeah, it's great. Works great for me. Yeah. Okay. Let me explain a bit more about that. Yep. 在刚刚这边的话有提到其实在今年十月份的时候，他们有和 Firecoin 团队来推出了和 MoNA 啊 Firecoin 团队一起推出了一个赏金计划啊，类似有一个$30,000的这样一个赏金计划。那在赏金计划里面的话呢，其实鼓励更多的人在 Metaverse 里面可以创建自己的这样一个 space。OK， 那他这边的话呢，其实也有提到，就是MoNA 这边的话完全集成了RPFS 相关的技术，你完全就可以通过 Chrome 浏览器，你就可以去随意的访问任何的这样作品，不管你在任何地方、任何时间，你只要打开你的浏览器，你都可以访问这些非常好看的这些MoNA 创建的这种 space。OK， 那他这边的话呢有提到就是你直接在 Chrome 网页里面打开，然后你动动键盘，你就可以操作这些不同的场景，你都可以像这个屏幕里面的小人一样，你可以到访不同的房间，然后去体验不同的space。 OK, great, Justin, yeah, you can move on now, thanks.
Okay, great, thank you. So I'm just going to continue to jump into some of these spaces that were built by some incredible artists in the community. We have really amazing Discord, by the way. If you'd like, you can dive right in and meet some of the creators and collectors that are in there. But you'll see a lot of these spaces were built specifically, you know, in mind with the Filecoin Forum Build-A-Thon. And we have artists with us who are traditionally, you know, from all backgrounds, 3D design, architecture. You know, we have a lot of artists that are traditionally game designers who are working on many AAA game titles such as Cyberpunk, you know, Assassin's Creed. And so it's really amazing to see the community of artists who are not only building these metaverse spaces, but many of which are completely new to Web3. And so some of these artists have never even, you know, created a Web3 wallet before. And so this is their first time like helping them set up a MetaMask even. So it's a really exciting time. And we're really excited to be onboarding a ton of new creators to Web3 and introducing them to IPFS as well.
Yeah, okay, great. Yeah, 刚刚在张行这边的话他有提到就是你直接可以就 dive into 这样整体的这样一个 metaverse 里面去，就直接就可以进入这样一个空间。其实很多的他在 MoNA 这边看到的这些非常好看的这些 space， 其实都是由其他的一些社区的一些艺术家他们所创建的。那可能对于很多其他一些艺术家的话，他可能没有其他没有一个这样比较好的这样一个生态环境可以让他们直接可以进入然后来创建自己的这种可以来发挥自己的这样一个创造空间。对，但是在 MoNA 这边的话就完全可以一起加入进来来创建非常好玩的 space。 OK, great, yeah, you can move on now.
Great, thank you. And so what we're really excited about is, you know, with MoNA being able to give creators the platform and flexibility to create any space that's in their head in any visual style. And so you'll see there's a wide range of visual styles, you know, from science fiction to, you know, and more sort of like very, very highly stylized to something that's maybe even more photorealistic. And so, you know, with MoNA, we're removing a lot of the technical limitations for artists to be able to create even photorealistic worlds and being able to allow them to easily export and host the files using IPFS.
Yeah, great. Yeah. Did I just see the forum, Farcon forum there?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. So this is one of the spaces for that was submitted and one of the winners of the Filecoin forum. And so this wow. artist created this space with a bunch of these different screens. What's great about Mona is that not only are these beautiful immersive worlds that you can explore, but we're building out the functionality for a space owner to actually be able to go in and import NFTs from your own collection to display and share in the metaverse. And so this artist, Patrick, he actually created these screens with that very idea in mind. So as a space owner, you know, if I own this space, I would actually be able to go in and customize the images that are on these panels to show NFTs from my own collection in my wallet. You know, and that goes also for 3D NFTs as well. So this floating, you know, object would be a 3D object that I could import from my collection. And so that's a really great use case for Mona. We're working on that functionality now for all space holders. In addition to, you know, the functionality we have, which is being able to connect your space via portals. So inside of Mona, you know, you're able to collect spaces, and then if you're a space owner, you can actually change what portal or what spaces your space is also connected to. So a little bit different from other traditional metaverses where you have to purchase a plot of land and you're locked into sort of a place on a map. Inside of Mona, there's no sort of set space in the map. It's very, very open. And so it allows you the flexibility to be able to connect your space to any other space that you'd like. And some spaces can have one portal in them. Some spaces can have 5 or 10. You know, the sky's the limit there. And so, you know, we're just really excited about being able to give artists and collectors the opportunity to own a space in the metaverse that is not locked into a position on a map, that can be photorealistic, that you can have a multiplayer experience with others. So these are fully multiplayer experiences now. You can see at the bottom, I have the host hangout beta version. So I can actually click host, and this would generate a shareable link for me to send to you. And we'd be able to both be in the web browser at the same time with voice chat and everything. So it's really, really excited to be able to provide these sort of features to artists and collectors in the space. And it's really important to us that all of the users of the metaverse are able to participate in ownership. And so that's why it's so important, everything we're building, you know, with Filecoin, with IPFS, that we really are seeding and building the open decentralized metaverse.
Okay, wow, great. Okay, great. Okay, let me try to explain a bit more about that. Yeah, okay, yeah. 刚刚Justin这边的话有提到就是 你可以作为一个这个 space 的 owner, 就是你可以就拥有这块 space, 对,拥有这个空间, 拥有在MoDA里面的这个空间。 但是呢，你也可以与其他更多的人去交互，你甚至可以，刚刚他有提到一个链接，对吧？一个 link， 你点一下那个 link 的话，你可以把这个链接分享给其他更多的人，他们都可以参与到你这样一个 space 里面来，就是类似于一种，大家在打游戏里面的一个多人在线游戏的这样一个环节。那在这样一个 space 里面的话，你就不会一个人感觉到孤单或者怎样，对吧？你可以与朋友在一起在这样一个虚拟的空间里面去进行一个交互。 那另外的话，它这边有提到一个，就是，它这个空间的话呢，并不是完全封闭的这样一个空间，对，不是封闭的。然后你可以和更多的一些其他的一些空间去进行交互，你也可以去访问其他人的空间，然后你甚至可以像刚才提到了一个，扮演多重角色一样，对吧？你可以进入其他人的空间，然后去和其他人一起，可以类似在一个虚拟空间里面去开会啊，或者是游玩，或者是去看一下别人的一个 space 大概是什么样子的，都可以实现这样一个功能。对，那 MoNA 这边的话，在嘉欣刚刚有提到，就是他们就是集成了 IPFS 和 Farcon， 就是希望让更多的人都可以访问这样一个 space， 并且完全是一个非常开放的这样一个平台，给艺术家也好，给 owners 也好，给拥有这个空间的人也好，或者是想参与到这样一个空间里面的人，都完全可以去参与进来。OK, Jason, yeah, you can move on now. Thanks.
Okay, great. Thank you. Actually, Tim, now might be a great time. You know, we dove into some of the metaverse spaces. You know, I can kind of show, you know, all the spaces right now are available for purchase on OpenSea. We're very well integrated with OpenSea at the moment. And so everything, if you actually go to mona.gallery/collect, that would be the link that would take you to all of the space listings we have here. But this might be a great opportunity for me to dive into a demo for someone who might want to create a space, if that sounds okay.
Yeah, great. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So if you're an artist or if you know of any creators and you'd like to actually start to build your own space to mint, the process is very simple and straightforward. On the MoNA website, there's this build a space link. This takes you to our documentation that goes through, you know, you can see we break down all the different layers of MoNA, spaces, artifacts, and portals. And then to get started, you know, all you have to do is download Unity. Everything in MoNA is built on top of Unity, which is a really incredible game engine. Unity is completely free to download and free to use. So you can do that. And then we have a template for a space starter that's all available on GitHub. So you can download our space starter on template on GitHub. And then basically you can dive right into Unity, which I've opened up here already. And this is sort of what you see when you open it up. And so I basically just want to take you through the process and show you how easy it is to build a metaverse space inside of Unity, upload it to MoNA, and then eventually get ready to mint it. So inside of the Unity template here, we have some template objects set up. And basically what I would do is now in any 3D creation tool of my choice, be it Blender or Maya or Cinema 4D, I'm able to create 3D assets, and then I can actually import them here and just drag and drop them right into this Unity template. So already I have this sort of cliff object that I've created, and I've created a material for it as well. So you can see I've got like this, you know, rocky kind of cliff here. And, you know, I can make a bunch of adjustments to my scene. And then when I'm ready to sort of test this in the web browser, all I have to do is go up to this MoNA menu and click Build Playground Files. And so this is going to build the playground files for me to go and test it. If you want, I can pause it if you want to explain that or...
Yeah, I can explain a bit about that. Yeah, the whole process, I think, is very user-friendly, artist-friendly for that. Yeah, okay, yeah. Let me try to explain about this. Yeah, 那刚刚其实Justin这边的话是我们大家展示了就是如何去 mint 这样一个 space 这样一个 NFT， 然后并且可以把它通过制作，然后后面的话可以上传到 OpenSea 这样平台，也可以当然也可以集成就是把 你现有的一些 NFT 的元素就可以上载到这样一个里面去 ，OK， 那这边的话呢，其实你要创建一个MoNA 这边的一个 space 也是或者是 Mint 这样一个 space 也是蛮简单的，就是你去到 MoNA 的官网，对吧？上面有一个 Mint space， 然后你点击它，然后它就会有一个非常一个详细的教程来教你来做这些东西，然后你里面的话可以看到一个类似 Docs 的这样一个东西，然后里面有 Portal 啊，然后有帮 教你如何去安装 Unity 这样的一些东西，然后你也可以，当然这些东西是完全免费的哈。你下载完之后呢，你就可以去安装完 Unity 之后呢，我看到就可以去制作了。对，你可以去直接开始创作，或者说你有之前有一些 NFT 的一些元素或者作品的话，或者是一些其他一些材料，你都可以把它上载到这样一个空间去。然后另外呢，你把这些空间自动完这些空间呢，你也可以直接 upload 到 OpenSea 里面去。 然后你就可以，你可以去赚钱或者怎样，对，都可以。另外的话呢，你也可以把你现有的一些材料，然后添加到这个空间来，然后你可以在里面开始进行你的艺术创作，发挥你的灵感。Okay, yeah, you can move on now. Thanks.
Okay, perfect. Thanks. Okay, so I've built my playground files. So now that's actually going to open them up in a folder on my desktop. So now I'm going to jump back over to Google Chrome. The next step is to go to mona.gallery/playground, where I'll actually be able to upload these files. So I'm gonna drag and drop the playground files that were created right here, and it's going to upload the space to MoNA, and I'll be able to dive right in and start running around to explore. So just like that, in no time at all, really, I was able to go from the Unity template where I've imported some 3D assets that I've created, and then I clicked the Build Playground Files button, and now I'm actually in the web browser exploring that environment that I have inside of Unity.
Wow, so great. It's like a move from a, like, from a 2D environment, move it into a playground and make it like a 3D environment here. Is that so?
Yeah, exactly. We're going from having the environment in Unity, kind of constructing it and architecting it here, you know, and then you build the playground files, and then you're able to upload them directly to MoNA web apps that you can jump in with your avatar and start to explore.
Okay, great.
Yep. Yeah. And then, you know, so from there, this is sort of like to test everything. Once I'm happy with my scene, you know, typically I would do a bit more to build out a nicer space. But just for the example here, you know, once I'm ready to go, the next step would be to actually click build mintable files. So whenever my scene's ready, I'm going to click that button. Now I'm going to head back over to the web browser. And instead of the playground, which is just for testing, I would then navigate to mona.gallery/wallet. And so this prompts me to log in with my MetaMask account. And so this brings me to my space drafts page. So when I'm ready to actually upload a space and mint one, I'm going to click start a new space. I'll be able to enter some details about myself, my space title. I'm going to call this Rock Room, and a short description about the space. So this is a quick test. All right. And I'll also be able to select a space theme at the bottom, and I can select one or many themes here and continue. And then on the next page here, I'll be able to upload those playground files that I previously had. So I would just drag and drop the playground files here. I'll be able to upload a preview image. The mintable file would be uploaded here, and also a preview render, a quick video render of the space. Now, what's really exciting about this is uploading these playable files here and the mintable file here. This is actually going to upload the files directly to IPFS to be dynamically loaded whenever a user visits the space. So I would then click the upload button here, and this would upload the space and begin that process. And when it's finished, it'll actually give me a shareable link that will be permanent. And so, you know, when you reach this step, you'll actually be able to create a shareable link that you can then share with anyone to start testing out your space. I'll just upload all these different things here. And then there's a quick QA process. You know, our MoNA team goes through and makes sure your space and everything is set up correctly. And once that's done, you'll be able to actually mint the space all from the MoNA wallet.
Oh, cool. Yeah, thanks, Justin. Let me try to explain this process. Yeah, I think it's pretty simple and easy for artists to do so. Yeah. Okay, great.
Yep.
Yeah, 刚刚 Justin这边的话，其实大家可以看到他通过Playground的话呢，把刚刚的一个 所创建的一些材料的话，都可以在这样一个 program 里面的话，可以把它做 3D 化，对 ，3D 然后虚拟现实化，然后并且的话呢，它可以看到就是你在这个 program 里面创作的这些元素也好，这个场景这个 space 也好，后面的话你可以把它非常通过一些简单的方式，你都可以把它上传到OpenSea 里面去 upload 你刚刚所创造的这样一个作品。对，然后也可以去分享给其他人。然后他刚刚其实有一个步骤的话，类似你可以来去用那个MetaMask 账户去 login 它，对不对？去登录进来之后的话，你就可以开始点击就 start new space， 对吧？你可以创建一个新的 space 在这边，然后你可以简单的填一些资料或者是。一些东西啊，然后或者是你的一些主题啊，或者是 theme 啊这些东西，然后你都可以看到一个比较好的一个展现，你也可以去 preview 它，然后可以看它的一些 render 现在一些东西，然后等它上传完之后呢，它其实是完全和 IPFS 进行交互的，然后你所有这些东西的话都可以无缝和 IPFS 衔接，然后的话呢，你等你上传完之后，它会有一个 link 给到你，然后这个 link 的话，你可以 share 给你的一些。朋友，对，并且非常方便去 share 给你的朋友一起去展现它。 Okay, yeah, great. Thanks, Justin. Yeah, you can move on now. Okay.
Oh, great. Thank you. So actually, as you were explaining that, my space finished uploading to IPFS here, and wow. It actually was able to sense a couple of artifacts that I tagged in the space. Mm-hmm. So jumping back to Unity, I could just quickly show you, you know, inside of Mona, we have everything separated from the space layer to the artifact NFT layer and the portal layer. And so I actually have these two objects, which would be my 3D NFTs, just as templates in the project to show you how it works. So Mona, the web app, was actually able to sense that those were in there. And then from there, I can actually link these artifacts to NFTs that I own that might be listed on a couple of example marketplaces like OpenSea, Super Rare, and others. So I actually can go through and create a link for those artifacts when I jump in. And this is the preview link that's generated that I can then go through and actually test my space live in Mona and share this for anyone to then join me inside of Mona. So really exciting, really easy process for anyone to get started. And then, yeah, and there you go. And so you're able to actually go through and see how that works. Just to show you the artifact, I don't have that linked, but yeah, that's sort of like the quick overview of everything. And so I can dive in more, or I'd be happy to answer any questions. I should also note, when you're minting, artists do have a choice to mint on either Polygon or Ethereum. So we love that, you know, we're able to offer both options right now. We're looking forward to integrating other chains in the future as well.
Wow, great. Okay, thanks, Justin. Yeah. 刚刚我在解释的时候，其实大家可以看到那个东西都已经上载完毕了。然后上载完毕之后呢，嘉欣这边的话，其实已经把这样一个作品可以完全展现给大家，然后也可以把这样一个链接就可以分享给您的朋友。然后它已经集成在 MoNA 这个里边来了，所以你可以看到一个机器人它在浏览这样一个空间。OK， 那刚刚嘉欣也有提到的话，就是后面的话这块也会和。以太坊 Polygon 这边的话都会集成，然后你也可以通过其他链的生态，你也可以访问进来，然后你也可以在 MoNA 里面创造你的这样一个作品。那我们的话接下来就会进入下一个环节，因为刚刚现在就是嘉欣这边又给我们分享了关于 MoNA 现在在做什么，如何使用，你作为一个艺术家的话，你如何创建在 MoNA 里面创建这样一个 space， 对吧？大家发现还是。蛮有趣的啊，我觉得大家可以感兴趣的话可以去尝试去做一下，整个流程的话其实也非常简单，他们已经有非常完备的教程在这个里边了。那OK， 那我们接下来的话进入下面的环节，我们会针对一些问题和 Justin 里面会进行一些探讨。OK， yeah， thanks a lot Justin， yeah， let me share my screen and we do have a few questions for you and hope you can answer more questions about that， yeah， okay，
definitely，
great，
thank you。
Yeah, the very first one is, you know, how do you have the idea, you know, to create a MoNA project, and why do you choose to build it with IPFS and Barcoin? You know, yeah, just now you mentioned a bit about, you know, three best friends gather together and to have an idea like to build a MoNA. Yeah, maybe you can try to tell us a bit more about that. Thanks.
Definitely. Yeah. Thanks, Tim. That's a really great question. Yeah. You know, earlier this year, Matt, Alex and I, we just saw all the hype that was happening in the NFT space. You know, we were inspired by a ton of digital artists, like really coming through and finding a lot of success with NFTs. Artists like Beeple, you know, obviously his $69 million sale of his piece, you know, that when that caught wind, I think a lot of these marketplaces got more and more attraction and attention. And so, you know, for Matt, Alex and I, we saw a really great opportunity to be able to provide a very high quality photorealistic way for artists and collectors to start to display and share their work in 3D. You know, we saw that as, you know, something that was sort of lacking, that there wasn't really a great way to display 3D work at a high fidelity. And so we started building this virtual gallery concept, and eventually it grew into this larger metaverse concept. And, you know, we see it as, everyone is spending so much time in virtual worlds already. We're on Zoom connected in the metaverse virtually. And so, you know, we see this growing to be bigger and bigger. And so for us, it's really important that the metaverse stay decentralized and stay open. And so, you know, we saw IPFS and Filecoin And, you know, we're really aligned with Filecoin and IPFS and being able to store all this data for years and years and years into the future. And we want to make sure that all the NFTs and the 3D files and the assets for the metaverse are able to be stored for years to come. And so, you know, we love everything that Protocol Labs, Filecoin, you know, are building, and, you know, we loved IPFS to be able to serve these very large 3D files. You know, the files that we're uploading, you know, we have a file size limit of around 200 megabytes. And so that's the largest of any other platform. And so, yeah, we really love that we're able to be able to upload everything on IPFS, and it's able to serve it like super quickly to be able to provide a really great user experience. So yeah, I think that was pretty much it. It's just, we were inspired to create virtual galleries for artists and collectors. And then we were inspired to help artists and collectors build and own pieces of the metaverse.
Okay, wow, great. Yeah, thanks, Justin. Yeah. Okay, yeah, 那其实刚才 Justin 这边有提到，就是我们刚刚其实在分享这边有提到，就是三个朋友，然后大家就是有针对接下来这样一个NFT 加密生态吧，或者是艺术生态，然后他们达成了一致的想法，所以他们创建了这个 MoNA。那其实他们是在今年早些时候，就是大家碰到在一起的。正好在今年早些时候的话，大家也看到 NFT 这样一个整体的发展的热潮，对吧？大家看到 Beep 的那一幅画卖了非常非常多的价钱，然后很多人开始感觉到，哎，这个行业好像开始有一些吸引力了。很多类似家庭也好，或者是他的一些朋友，开始看到这样一个这样一个吸引力在这边。然后也是非常的火爆吧，最近这个 NFT 市场这边也是非常非常火爆，包括我们也看到 OpenSea 啊，或者是其他一些交易市场的一些表现，对吧？大家都看到非常好的这样一种表现，所以很多数字艺术家也开始过来。但他们过来之后呢，他们并不是只是说创建一些简单艺术作品，然后在 OpenSea 平台上去发售就完了。他们的想法其实更加的是希望能够创建类似 MoNA 这样一个平台，让更多的艺术家可以来 MoNA 这边来进行创作，然后你创作这个东西呢，它其实并不只是一个简易的这样一个 MT 的这样一个作品，你还可以在这样一个创建一个类似一小块元宇宙的感觉，对吧？其实这个空间的话，就类似你的个人的一小块元宇宙的这种感觉，然后你可以创建自己的这样一个这样一个 space 空间，然后呢，你也可以和其他更多的人去进行分享。那他也是提到为什么要用 IPFS 和 Barcon 来开始去构建它。那其实他也提到，就是CSS 这边也好，包括 Barcon 官方团队也好，一直对于近期的 AMD 的这样一个存储是非常非常支持的，对吧？我们也可以看到，他们之前有发布过一些类似 AMD Storage 或者是类似这样的一些项目吧。对，我们也看到这些东西的话，完全可以存储在 IPFS 网络当中来。那也像跟 Justin 刚刚提到的一样，就是可能一个3D 的这种 space 的话，也可以达到200兆的这样一个空间，最起码要有200兆，这是一个非常庞大的东西。那大家可以想，只是一个就已经200兆，那其实那么多的作品的话，可能要占用更多，然后你还要去考虑去备份，对不对？所以这些东西的话，会对这样一个存储的要求非常高。另外还有非常极为重要的一点，就是我们要确保这样一个 AMD 存储的这种独一无二，对吧？它的安全性它的独一无二性，那如何去确保呢？通过 IPFS 网络你可以来实现这一点，所以他们也是为什么选择会用 IPFS 网络来开始去构建它。那当然也像但是最后面也提到一样，他们还是会创建一个比较开放的这种非常 open 的这样一个空间去给到艺术家，然后你可以在里面去创建，然后发挥你的才能和灵感，对，然后去构建很多不同的这种元宇宙的空间在这边。 OK, yeah, thank you so much, Justin. Yeah, and we do have another question about that. And as you know, yeah, Metaverse is a trend for now. A lot of people are talking about that, but we do see some of the critics said maybe this is not the next big thing. Maybe this thing, maybe it's just kind of like a bubble that will soon be, you know, burst. And yeah, and so as you know, you are already working with the metaverse and building so many great metaverse space with MoNA, right? Yeah. So we do want to know, yeah, how do you see about the metaverse actually? Yeah. Thanks.
Definitely. That's another really great question. The metaverse is here to stay. It's been around for so long. And I think now, the growth has been so accelerated by advancements in hardware, with things like the Oculus Quest and Quest 2, at a very accessible price point for a lot of consumers. But in addition to even VR and AR headsets that are being developed, you have so much activity just even in the web browser on the desktop. I think more than half of my day is spent on Zoom connecting with people in virtual spaces. And so we're already connecting virtually. Just the next step is then to be able to alter the medium by which we're connecting virtually and, being able to alter and control kind of that space that we're in. And so with a metaverse platform like MoNA here, we're able to take it the next step further, where not only are we able to connect, via voice and video, but now, we can actually join a shared space in a multiplayer environment, and actually kind of have that sense of presence and spatial presence with other participants. And so, I think there are always sort of, you'll see different sort of trends emerge. And obviously the NFT space is very, very hot right now. But aside from that, the metaverse is definitely a concept that is going to be here to stay for years into the future. If we've learned anything from this pandemic that we're going through now, it's that more and more people are spending more and more time and more of their days online in virtual spaces. And so we're really excited to be able to provide that next step forward where, we can have a shared experience inside of a really beautiful, artistically designed virtual spaces and virtual worlds that we can now own a piece of.
Okay, wow. Okay, thank you, Justin. Yeah, okay. Yeah. 那刚刚 Justin 这边提到的话，其实， 不管怎么样，元宇宙已经存在了，对吧？然后可能很多人对我们来讲的话，元宇宙只是一个可能目前来讲还是一个概念性的一个东西。但是也正如Justin刚才所讲，可能接下来几年的话，我们都要围绕这样一个概念继续往下走了。那为什么这么说呢？其实他有提到，就是目前的这样一个pandemic，我们的这样一个疫情这样一个疫情期间，对吧？这个疫情还是非常严重的。那我们大家倾向于更多的一些交互方式，可能还是走的 线上的这种方式会比较多一些，那大家可能更多的在虚拟空间的这种交互，可能接下来会变得越来越多啊。就像嘉欣提到，他其实每天的话会花费大多数的时间在 Zoom 上面进行meeting 或者是交流，对。那其实对我们现在的其实大家都一样，对吧？我们也在疫情期间经历了线上办公这样的环境，对吧？那其实对我们很多人来讲的话， 是否我们要考虑的是在虚拟现实当中也会有正常的不只是工作，还有生活，对，还有创造自己所喜爱的东西。那正好MoNA这边他是提到，他们就会致力于来做这样一个东西，在元宇宙当中的话，达到自己的这样一个空间，对，达到自己的这样一个 space。然后另外他也有提到，就是还是希望能够让更多的人实现在元宇宙之中，或者是在 接下来的这样一个虚拟世界当中能够有更多的一些交互在里面，对，你不只是说创建一个 NFT 的一个产品，一幅画或者是一个作品，然后就 OK 了。我们他其实希望的是能够通过这些不同的 3D 的这种空间的打造，能够让更多的人可以交互到一起，可以融入进来，可以来打造你的自己的一个类似小元宇宙的这样一个东西，你也可以去拥有它。 Okay, yeah, thank you so much, Justin. Actually, I do want to talk a bit more about that, about the amazing projects that you guys are building. So actually, you mentioned a bit more about like you were integrated with Ethereum, maybe a Polygon later on, right? So could you just tell us a bit more about the roadmap, like with MoNA and the next move, and so yeah, we are very, very interested about that. Yeah, okay.
Yeah, definitely. So there's a lot of things on a roadmap. Right now we've made it easy for any creator to upload and mint a space. We've launched our marketplace integration with OpenSea, and so now anyone can go on OpenSea and start collecting spaces inside of MoNA. You know, we launched the feature to be able to, you know, link your artifacts inside of a space that you built, all via the MoNA wallet. And just last week, we rolled out our multiplayer beta feature. And so now we can actually have those shared experiences with voice chat all in the web browser. One of the very next things that we're working on is customizable avatars. So we're actually integrating with Ready Player Me to bring customizable avatars to MoNA spaces. And so you're able to actually customize your avatar through these, you know, through the Ready Player Me integration. So really excited about that. Other things on our roadmap, we're going to have the ability for anyone to be able to link and edit NFTs directly from your wallet to your MoNA space. You'll be able to basically drag and drop NFTs that you have in your collection right into your MoNA space to go live in MoNA, all from the MoNA web app. So that's a really important feature for collectors to be able to sort of like edit some of the NFTs that they have on display. And so we're working on getting that ready. You know, we're also going to be planning our VR integration with everything that's accessible over the web browser. Very soon, you'll also be able to access everything via a VR headset like the Oculus Quest 2. You know, that's a very, obviously it's a very, very important feature for us. And so we want to be able to get that out there very soon. And we're also looking at how the AR space is developing. You know, we're looking at sort of integrating an AR feature all via your phone and mobile device. But then we're also looking very closely at Apple as we wait for them to release their Apple AR headset, you know, which could be a little ways off, but we're going to slowly start to integrate more AR functionality until the AR hardware is ready as well. You know, so those are just a few things on the roadmap. We have some other things like artist profiles and collector profiles, so you'll be able to actually have kind of like your own URL and your own homepage in MoNA to show off the spaces that you own. So that'll be ready to go pretty soon as well. And then on the minting side of things, right now we're integrated with Polygon Ethereum. Next year, we actually plan to be integrated with Algorand. That's going to be one of the next chains that we're going to integrate with. And we're also looking at other you know, other chains as well. It's really important that you know, we sort of want to go carbon negative with our footprint. So integrating with something like Algorand is going to be very important to us. You know, so we're going to be working on that. We also have you know, we'd like to build out our own marketplace all inside of MoNA as well. So we're going to be working on that at some point next year as well. So there's a lot of really great, amazing, fun features, including, I'll also mention, we're going to be able to provide interactivity inside spaces. So as a space creator, you know, you could actually build your own sort of game inside of a MoNA space where your avatar can start to interact with some of the objects. And so we're going to be releasing that feature next year as well. So a lot of exciting things.
Wow, great. Yeah, look forward to that. Yeah, thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, 刚才在这边的话有提到就是接下来一个 roadmap, 对。那其实现阶段的话，现阶段也就是说他们手上已经在做的事情已经非常非常多了啊，比如说他们已经实现了和 OpenSea 这边的一个交互，然后他们也在构建一个多元化的一个角色参与，就类似 multiplayer, 可以在那个 space 里面可以看到有其他不同的角色，也可以在同一个 space 里面进行一个交互。然后他们接下来也会做一些类似非常火爆的现在的就是类似 Portable Punk 这样的一些头像，对吧？啊，定制化的一些头像。那另外的话呢，他们也是希望能够有一些不同的，能够把 MoNA 这边制造一些space 空间，能够和其他的一些 NFT 项目也可以 link 在一起，然后你可以再进行更多的一些创作或怎样啊，或者能够有更多的一些创作空间在这边。那另外的话他有提到可以 VR 和 AR 这边的话他们可能有更多的一些可能类似硬件设备的这样一个东西，类似你可以有一些头戴设备啊或者怎样，你可以戴上之后你可以完全进入到这个 MoNA 所创造的这一个非常漂亮的这样一个虚拟空间当中去。对， 那会展望接下来的可能下一年或者是更长远的这样一个时间的话来走的话呢，他有提到他们会实现和不同链的这样一个交互啊，当然他有提到说有和 Ethereum 和 Polygon 这边的一个交互之外呢，他们也是希望能够和更多的链，比如说像他提到 Algorand 这边也会实现一个交互，然后可能在接下来的很长一段时间内会实现不同链路生态的这样一个交互，能够把 MoNA 这边的 space 能够和不同的链去打通，然后能让更多的人可以融入到这样一个空间当中来，能够在这样一个 MoNA 这样一个元宇宙当中来能够创建自己的这样一片天空也好，或者是拥有自己的这样一个 space 在这边。Yeah, okay, yeah, thank you so much, Justin. Yeah, thank you for today. I think, we do occupy a lot of time here for today. We know you are very busy for now, so I think maybe that's the end for today, and later we will try to explain a bit more about MoNA to our audience here, and we will try to inform them about our more events later on. And okay, guys, yeah, just try to focus on MoNA, okay? Yeah, they are building very great things together here. Okay, thank you so much, Justin. Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Tim.
Yeah, okay, yeah, okay. See you next time, okay? Yeah, take care.
All right, see you next time. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.
Okay, bye bye, bye bye. Okay, thank you.好的，那今天这边的我们这边的一个活动可能就到这里了。我们也非常感谢嘉欣这边给我们带来一个非常精彩的这样一个线上分享和直播。那我们看到了你是如何在一桌 MoNA 如何去创建这样一个元宇宙空间，然后以及他们接下来一些 roadmap 以及非常好玩的一些东西都可以在 MoNA 在一个空间里面去展现。那我们也是期待他们可以接下来能够做得更好。好吗 ？OK， 那我们今天的活动的话，暂时就到这里。那我们近期的话也是有一些非常好的一些活动，比如说我们和另外一个Flow 生态的话也在推出一系列的一些相关活动，然后大家依然可以扫码参与到我们这样一个活动当中来。然后我们这边也是有准备了非常好的一些礼品，大家可以看到有类似一些非常精美的手袋啊，包括我们的发框相关的一些周边纪念品，以及还有一些非常好看的衣服啊，都在 Flow 这边Dapper Labs 这边所一起来定制的这样一些物品可以给到大家。就是参与方式的话，大家可以直接扫描我们屏幕上二维码，可以和我们的工作人员进行一个互动。OK， 非常感谢大家。那今天我们的活动就到这里，好吗？那另外还有一件事情可能要简单再提一下，就是近期我们的主体公司昆耀研究院这边的话呢，推出了元宇宙这样一本书 ，OK， 希望大家可以在接下来更多的关注。我们也在后面的活动当中呢，也会给大家做更多的这样一个阐述，关于这本书里面到底是我们对元宇宙的看法是怎么样的，以及如何助推元宇宙能够更好的去落地和发展，以及大家可以以怎样的方式可以参与到其中来，类似刚刚提到我们有MoNA 这边的 space， 对不对？那你其实可以在元宇宙当中可以还有更多的一些参与方式当中。那好的，那今天活动我们就到这里，那也请大家继续期待我们接下来的活动，好吗？ OK, thank you so guys everyone. Yeah, I think maybe that's the end for today. Yeah, we do have some cooperation with Flow here, and if you guys want to have some kind of swags here, you can just scan the QR code here and you can get involved and to participate our events. And we will continue to provide you guys about great updates about the Web3 ecosystem with so many great public chains like previously we featured like Polkadot and Farcon, and Farcon will be our next guest speaker later on. Yeah, so we do hope you guys can continue to follow up with our events, and we will also share with you guys about great projects like MoNA here today and like Functionland previously. Yeah, so yeah, just stay focused, okay? 好的，那今天我们活动的话就到这里，非常感谢大家。OK, 好的，拜拜。